In last lecture, we have seen what is path. That is path is nothing but the an open walk on which no vertex is repeated. Then such a walk is called as such a open walk is called as path. An open walk. No vertex is repeated. It's called as path. Called as path. And a path with n vertices is denoted by Pn, and length of such a path is n minus 1. The path with n vertices is denoted by Pn. And length of such a path is nothing but n minus 1. For example, let us see one graph. Suppose this one is the graph G in which there are 9 vertices and this one is 9 vertices and 14 edges. Now we have to see, now we have to take one path from this graph G. Let us take. This one is the first walk, and this one is the second walk. Then, by definition of path, a path is nothing but an open walk in which no vertex is repeated. Then, by definition of path, we have to check whether of these two walks, which one is the path. In this walk, vertex V1 is repeated, so this one is not a path. And in walk second, no vertex is repeated. Then, by definition of path, this one is the path. Now, let us see what is cycle. And close the walk. And close off in which no vertex is repeated. No vertex is repeated. Repeated. Except the end vertex. Such such a fluid walk is called cycle. Fluid walk in the a walk is said to be fluid if the air vortices of the walk are similar, and a closed walk in which no vortex is repeated except the air vortices, such a fluid walk is called as cycle. Or another definition of cycle is nothing but or a non-trivial closed train, non-trivial closed train is said to be cycle if the origin and internal vortices are distinct. If the origin and internal vortices of a train are distinct, these two definitions are equivalent. A non-trivial closed trail is stated to be a cycle if the origin and internal vortices of the trail are distinct. Trail is nothing but an walk in which no edge is repeated. Now, if the origin and internal vortices of the trail are distinct, then such a trail is nothing but the closed walk in which no vortex is repeated except the edge vortices. Now, let us take for example. If suppose this one is the graph G, then here first one this one is the first walk and this one is the second now, this one is the first walk W1. Suppose this one is the walk W1 and this one is the walk W2. Now we have to check whether W1 and W2 are cycle or not. In this walk W1, vortex V2 is repeated and vortex V2 is not the end vortex of a walk W1. Since by definition of cycle, a closed walk is stated to be a closed walk is said to be a cycle if the end if there is no vertex repeated except the end vertices. V2 is not an end vertex and V2 is repeated. So by the definition of cycle, it is not a cycle. Now this one is the walk W2 in which there is no vertex repeated except the end vertices. So by definition of cycle, this one is the cycle. Now, is path name and cycle name. This one is the graph G. Now let us see what is path name. Path name. The number of edges in which the path is covered. The number of edges in which the path covered. Is called as path length. It's called as path length. And the number of edges in which the cycle cover is called as cycle length. Now let us take one example of path and one example of cycle, and let us check what is the length of path and cycle. Suppose this one is the first one. Take path V1. This one is the path, and take second one as a cycle. By definition, let us check whether this one is the path. Path is nothing but an open walk in which no vertex is repeated. In this example, there is no vertex repeated. So, by the definition, which is a path, and by definition of cycle, it is an closed walk in which no vertex is repeated except the end vertices. Here is vertex V1 is repeated, and other than vertex V1, there is no vertex which is repeated in the walk, in this walk. So by definition, this one is the cycle. Now, a path length is nothing but the number of edges in which the path is path covered. So here there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 edges. Then by definition of path length, the path length of this path is 5. Path length is 5. And cycle length is nothing but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here cycle length is also 5. Now, let us check what is the width of a graph. The length of a smallest cycle, in a graph, is called length of a graph. Here, the first condition. First, we have to take the cycle and which one is the smallest cycle in this graph. So, here, now, this one is the cycle and length of this cycle is length of this cycle is 4. But in another cycle V1, V2, V11, V9, V10, and length of this cycle is 3. So by definition of girth of a graph, the girth of graph, this graph G is 3. Since in this graph G there is no cycle which is of length less than 3. If we take any cycle in the graph, this graph G, then we can't get a cycle which is of length less than 3. So by definition of a girth of a graph, the girth of a graph G is 3. Similarly, the circumference of a graph G is nothing but circumference of a graph. The length of the largest cycle in a graph G, largest or longest cycle in a graph is called as circumference of a graph. This one is the cycle of length 6. It is a cycle length, cycle of length 6. In this graph G, there is no cycle which has length greater than 6. Here we can't find out any cycle which has the length greater than the 6. Hence, by definition of circumference of a graph, the circumference of a graph, this graph G is nothing but 6. Circumference will be equal to, which is nothing but the circumference of graph. Now, there are some nodes. First, every path is a walk. Every path is a walk, but conversion need not be. Need not be. Every path is a walk. Since let us see what is path. An open walk in which no vertex is repeated, then such a walk is called as path. As it is open walk is nothing but then it is a walk in which the end vertices are different. Then by definition of walk, the open walk is always a walk. So every path is a walk, but converse need not be true. Let us take one example. Suppose V1, V2, V11, V9, V10, and V1. A walk is nothing but if it is an alternating sequence of vertices and edges, then by definition of walk, this one is a walk. But let us see whether it is a path. A path is nothing but the open walk in which no vertex is it is an open walk in which no vertex is repeated. So by the definition of path, this one is not an open walk, since Open walks is that an walk in which no, in which the end vertices are distinct. But here vertex V1 is the origin and terminus of the of this walk, and which is repeated. So by definition of open walk, this one is not a open walk. So it is a walk, but not a path. As it is not an open walk, so it is not a path. So every path is a walk, but converse need not be true. Now, every cycle is a closed the walk, but converse need not be true. But converse need not be. Now, let us see what is first closed walk and cycle. A closed walk is nothing but an walk in which no vertex. A walk is said to be closed walk if the end vertices of the walk are end vertices of the walk are same. And cycle is nothing but it is a closed walk in which no vertex is repeated except the end vertices. And suppose if W1 is a cycle, then as it is cycle, then it is a closed walk in which no vertex is repeated except the end vertices. Except the end walk. As it is a closed walk, then every cycle is a closed walk. Now I have to check whether every closed walk is a cycle. If we can give one example which is a closed walk but not a cycle, then we can say that the converse did not be true. That is, may or may not be true. Now, let us check whether this walk is a closed walk. A closed walk is nothing but it is a walk whose end vertices are same. Here vertex B2 is same. That is, vertex B2 is terminus and origin of the walk W. So by the definition of closed walk, this one is the closed walk. Now let us check whether this one is the cycle. Cycle is nothing but a closed walk in which no vertex is repeated except the end vertices. Here this walk W is a closed walk, but vertex V3 is repeated in this walk. So by the definition of cycle, this one is not a cycle. So we can say that every closed walk need not be a cycle. So from this we can conclude that every cycle is a closed walk, but converse need not be true. Now, third point is a single vertex is a path of length. Path is nothing but the open walk in which no vertex is repeated. As we can take this one in here is vertex given. This one is the vertex V1. By the definition of path, here is no vertex is repeated in this walk. So this graph G is called an path. Or if we can take any vertex from a graph with this graph G, then it is a, by definition of path, it is a path. But path length is nothing but the number of edges in which the path is covered. But here there is no edge. So length of this path is G. Now, a single vertex with a single loop
is a closed wall. Suppose this is a vertex B, a single vertex with a single loop, and this one is at least
even.
So a single vertex with a single loop is a closed walk. Closed walk is nothing but an walk whose end vertices are similar. So here we can take one walk. The end vertices of this walk are same. Then by the definition of closed walk, this one is the closed walk. So we can say that a single vertex with a single loop is a closed walk. That is, it is a cycle of length. It is a cycle of length one. Cycle is nothing but the closed walk in which no vertex is repeated except the end vertices. As here there is only one vertex and which is origin and terminus of the walk. So here there is no vertex which is repeated except the end vertex. So by the definition of this one is a cycle. And here there is only one end. So the length of this cycle is one.
Single page. If we can take any single edge from any graph G whose end vertices are different, then this one is the path of length 1. If suppose we can take the edge EA, then we have two distinct vertices VA and V2. EA. And length of this path is 1. Now, let us take the next one more piece. The path of minimum integral in between the minimum integral in the path of minimum length joining between any two vertices of graph G is nothing but the shortest path joining between these two vertices. Let us see from this graph G.
Now we have to see which one is the shortest path joining between the any two vertices, that is the vertices V1 and V4. This one is the path from vertex V1 to V4. The path is nothing but the open walk in which no vertex is repeated, as here there is no vertex is repeated. So this one is the path and which join two vertices V1 and V4. So this one is the path from vertex V1 to V4, and this one is again a path joining between the two vertices V1 and V4. But this one is the path of minimum length joining between these two vertices. Since length of this path is 3 and length of this path is 5, but this path is the minimum length joining between the two vertices. So this path is called as shortest path joining between the two vertices. Now let us see what is a connected path. Connected a graph. A graph is stated to be connected. A graph is stated to be connected if it cannot be written as cannot be written or expressed as this disjoint union of otherwise it is said to be disjoint. So any graph G is said to be a connected graph if it cannot be written as a disjoint union of two subgraphs of this graph G. If we can write it as a disjoint union of two subgraphs, then this graph is called as a disconnected graph. Or definition is nothing but a graph is connected if every two of its vertices are connected. That is, there is a path joining between any two vertices of a graph G. Then such a graph G is called as a connected graph. If the graph is not connected, then such a graph is called as a disconnected graph. Let us see by taking example. This one is the graph G. Here, for this graph G can't be expressed as a disjoint union of two subgraphs. So, by definition of connected graph, this graph G is a graph G1 is a connected graph. Now,
as this graph G can't be expressed as a disjoint union of two subgraphs, so this graph G is connected. Similarly, in graph G2, for graph G2, it can't be written as this graph G2 as a disjoint union of two subgraphs. So this graph G2 is also a connected graph. But in graph G3, we can write this graph G3 as a disjoint union of two connected subgraphs. That is, one is the connected subgraph V1, V2, V3, and another one is the V4, V1, V3. And union of these two subgraphs G5 and G6. Union of these two subgraphs G5 and G6 is nothing but the graph G4. So this graph G4, sorry, graph G3 can be written as a disjoint union of two subgraphs of G3. So by definition of graph, connected graph, disconnected graph, this one is the disconnected graph. This one is the connected, this one is the disconnected graph. Similarly, this graph G4 can be expressed as a disjoint union of two subgraphs. One subgraph contains what I just given with V3 and another subgraph contains V4, V5 and V6. And union of these two subgraphs is nothing but the graph G4. So by definition of disconnected graph, this one is the disconnected graph. Connected graph. Now let us see what is a maximal connected subgraph. A connected subgraph which is not properly contained in G, not properly contained in G, under connected subgraph, any other connected subgraph is called maximal connected subgraph. Maximal connected subgraph is nothing but it is a connected subgraph which is not properly contained in any other connected subgraph of a graph. Same graph is called as maximal connected subgraph. Let us take one example. Now take two connected subgraphs of this graph. Let's take first graph G1 and this. This will be the graph G, which is subset of, sorry, which is subgraph of this graph G. And take G2 as a single vertex. Here, G1 as
voltages are zero. This one is about
G. This one is the graph G. Now, this one is the graph G, which has two connected subgraphs G1 and G2. As G1 is a connected subgraph, which is not properly contained in any other connected subgraph of graph G. It means, if suppose we can take G itself as a subgraph, then, but G is not a connected graph. So, this subgraph G1 is not properly contained in any other connected subgraph of graph G. So, by definition of maximal connected subgraph, this one is the maximal connected subgraph. Similarly, G2 is again not contained in any other connected subgraph of graph G. Since these two graphs are disconnected, since there is no path joining between the two vertices with V4. So, by definition, this one is the disconnected graph G. So, G2 is again a maximal connected subgraph since there is no connected subgraph in which G2 is properly contained. So, by definition of maximal connected subgraph, these two graphs are maximal connected subgraph. Here, take graph G as vertices V1, V2, V3, V4, and take G1 as this one, and G2 is nothing but this one. Here, G1 is properly contained in the graph G, and graph G is itself a subgraph and which is connected. So, by definition of maximal connected subgraph, this graph G1 is not a maximal connected subgraph. Similarly, graph G2, which is again a connected subgraph, but which is properly contained in subgraph G1. So, by definition of maximal connected subgraph, it is again not a maximal connected subgraph. G2 is also contained in a graph G, which is also a G is itself a subgraph. So, by again definition of maximal connected subgraph, G2 is not a maximal connected subgraph.